John Mountney, how are you?
All good, Jamie. You?
Great, thanks. Not too bad at all. Not too bad. Now, we're all very excited for Sunday, 4 o'clock against Bowes. And there's probably nobody in the Pats dressing room more experienced in FAI Cup finals than you. You've been involved in the last six with three wins and three losses with Dundalk and getting ready for a seven this Sunday. Now, unfortunately, you miss out through a knee injury, but I'm sure Alan and Stephen and the lads have loved having you around the group this week, adding your expertise.
Yeah, like you said, this is number seven now. You know, it's the most exciting day on the calendar year for anyone that's in the league. And lucky enough now, this is the seventh final. But like you said, watching this one, but looking forward to it. Been in all week watching the lads training, and you know, you can see the lads are really up for it. The tempo of training always goes up the week of a cup final. Everyone wants to play. So yeah, it's one everyone's looking forward to.
How are you feeling yourself injury-wise, and what's the latest on the recovery from the knee injury that you picked up actually away to Dundalk earlier in the summer?
Yeah, all's good. Everything, you know, ticking boxes all the time. There's been no issues. It's a lot of gym work and patience is the other one, though, so the balance between the two of them. But yeah, everything is going well, and look to be back playing by the start of next season.
Great stuff. So to focus on the cup for you, and you've been involved in so many, the last six in a row, as you mentioned, what comes to mind if I ask you about FAI Cup final day from a player's perspective?
I think, first of all, it's excitement. You know, I think, you know, everyone, you're always thinking of the cup final in the back of your mind in the league, whether you're fighting to win a league or, you know, you're fighting for to stay in it. It doesn't matter. Everyone that plays in the cup competition really wants to get to the Aviva. It's the most exciting day out for a player, for fans, for friends, for family, for everyone. And I think excitement is the first thing that comes to mind. Once you know, we had a tough journey to get to the cup final, like you always have to do. You have to beat some big teams to get there, and Pats have done that this year. So once we had beaten Dundalk in the semi final, I suppose the excitement's always there in the back of your head for the big day.
Yeah, everyone always speaks about, you know, looking back at it, and everyone picks a different reason for it being that big and that exciting. For you, what's the best thing about it?
I think playing in the National Stadium has to be the big one in front of a big crowd. You know, you're looking, hopefully this year we'll have 35,000 plus on the day. So that's the best thing about it. As a footballer, you want to play in the best grounds in front of big crowds. And, you know, that's where you really get the adrenaline going and feel like a proper footballer. So playing in the National Stadium is the best you can do, really.
Yeah, like the crowd, and it looks like it'll be the biggest FAI Cup attendance ever at the Aviva Stadium, touch wood. We're chatting on Wednesday evening, so by the time Sunday comes, hopefully it'll continue to push. The last update was 30,000 from the FAI, but a couple of the more recent finals that you were involved in, the Cork one in 2018 had over 30,000, the Shamrock Rovers Dundalk one in 2019 had almost 34,000 as well. From a player's point of view, how different is it when you're going from, say, 5,000 at Richmond in the semi-final, which is full to the brim against Dundalk, to the biggest football stadium in the country that's going to have the biggest crowd that maybe some of the lads would have never played in front of this number before either?
Yeah, of course, like you said, there's a big jump with you know, the attendance and all that, and of course the atmosphere will be more of a buzz than you've had before. Like you said, going from 4 or 5 to you know, to 30 plus, but like that, you don't think about it. And once you get out and you get warmed up, you get comfortable in the environment. Once kickoff goes, you know, you're fully focused on the match. So, you know, there should really be no issues with that. But I suppose it's a place where players strive, and like you said, it's new for a lot of lads. But, you know, knowing the personalities of the players we have in the dressing room that haven't been there before, they'll feed off that energy, and you know, they'll strive on the day, hopefully.
Yeah, the energy of the fans and the St. Pat's fans have been so brilliant this season with you guys, and even last year as well when they had to watch from home or wherever they watched the games as well. But like, how does that translate on the pitch? Like, if you're playing, like, you know, a fullback or wherever you're playing, you make a big tackle, you play a pass, you make a save, you clear a ball, you score a goal, and that roar that's just louder than any roar you've had all year has to just give you that extra little bit of kick if you need it.
Definitely. Fans have a massive part to play in. And, you know, the atmosphere that's been in Inchicore, you know, for us since we've come back has been brilliant. You can see our home form and, you know, the buzz around the stadium once the match gets going. And, you know, I'll urge all our St. Pat's fans to come out in their numbers, which I know they already are, and really get behind us, because it makes a massive difference on the day. I'm not sure what cup final was it, 2018 with Dundalk, or was it before that? It could have been 17, where you know, went to extra time, Dundalk played Cork, and I remember Stephen Kenny taking us down at extra time. You know, we were all out on our legs. We were all tired, of course, as you would be, and he brought us down to the home fans at the time, and, you know, they really got behind us. You could hear them roaring, and that gave us energy, you know, and something to feed off going into extra time. And like I said, it's massive, the fans, and the more noise they make on the day, you know, the more positivity we, like, the players would feed off that.
You think that was 2017, eventually went to penalties, Cork won on penalties. But I remember being at that match in the press
didn't
box.
Didn't work out too good in the end, me saying
no,
that.
But you're right. I remember seeing Stephen bringing you over, and it's something that you see managers all over the world have done before. And it's a special, special moment, like, when that happens. On the alternative side, probably more difficult to hear your teammates, to communicate, to hear the manager and stuff as well, which is a challenge that particularly those that haven't maybe played at the Aviva in front of those type of crowds before will have to get used to very quickly.
Yeah, that's the side we have been spoiled with as players since fans have been out, is, you know, communication from the sideline to the pitch is constant, you know, and it's easy to get information on. But like you said, different now with a full house, you know, that changes a bit. So that's where your players need to be communicating, and, you know, you're seeing your players take control a little bit on the pitch, you know, what they see in that moment. So, you know, we have a good mix of that anyway. So, you know, that should be no issue.
Yeah, and then, you know, in the group, we've got the head coach, Stephen O'Donnell, being involved in so many finals as a player. You got Alan Matthews, the manager, involved in lots of finals. I think he's getting ready for his eighth as a player and a manager. And then, you know, Chris Forrester and Burma won it with St. Pat's the last time. Robbie Benson's clearly been involved in a lot of the Dundalk ones that you've been in. And then there's some of the younger lads, and we, you know, there's no need to list them off, but, you know, even people like Lee Desmond, who's, you know, 26, Jamie Lennon, who's 23, who've been with the club for a long time, made lots of appearances. They've never played on this stage at this level as well. So it's really interesting for the ones that haven't been there to go and experience it for the first time. What have they been like this week, and are they extra excited?
You know, I don't think it'll affect them first and foremost, even being that age you're saying, Lee, and that 26, because, two lads are brilliant pros. You know, it won't phase them at all, and they'll enjoy that side of it as well, you know, playing for their club they've played with for so long in such a big occasion. But yeah, of course, like you said, everyone's excited, really. Why wouldn't you be? It's the best game you can be involved in come the end of the season, you know, when everyone's finishing up and, you know, going their off seasons, and you have a cup final to look forward to. So yeah, of course, all the lads are raring to go for it.
Yeah, I should have mentioned Shane Griffin as well. His experience, a cup winner with Cork City, I think would have been involved in a couple of those brilliant Cork and Dock games as well. And I know we were chatting off air there. You and him had a great battle in one of the games as well. And for this one, the opposition Bohemians and St. Pat's this season have been four very entertaining games. Most recently, the 2-2 at Richmond as well. And there's key battles, key 1v1s all over the pitch, which for people watching the game should be very, very interesting to see how it all unfolds.
Yeah, definitely. Bohs have, like you said, some very good individuals, and so do we. We were talking about off air before we come on about, you know, the cup finals in recent years, and a lot of it was Dundalk, Shamrock Rovers, Dundalk, Cork, and before that, of course, was Derry and Pats, where they last won it in 2014. But this is going to be a great game for the neutrals. You know, every time we've played St. Pat's, have played Bohs this year, it's been a cracker of a game. And like you said, a lot of good 1v1 battles and a lot of talent on display. So this will be a really exciting final, and one, you know, everyone should be looking forward to.
Yeah, the first all-Dublin final since 2000, the year 2000, should I say. Haven't even said the year 2000 in such a long time. You're always saying 2000 and something. So 21 years. And you mentioned the familiarity with the Cork Dundalk, and I loved those games and the rivalry that was there between Caulfield and Kenny and so on. And then Shamrock Rovers came along and been involved in the last few as well, and Dundalk have clearly been involved in the last six. But for it to be two new teams this year, two Dublin teams with, you know, lots of top players on show as well, it feels different. It feels like there's a freshness and a real interest in it, just because it's not the same teams involved in it.
Yeah, exactly. As a neutral, you know, you always want to see, I suppose, different. People are getting sick of them games. But being as a player, you'd never get sick of you know, playing in it. But of course, it's good for the neutrals, you know, to see, you know, two different clubs in it that haven't been in a long time, and two very exciting teams that both like to play attacking football, both get the ball on the ground. So, you know, like I said, this will lead to a great game for everyone to watch.
Talk me through, John, the players' experience on a cup final day. You've been involved in the last six. What's it actually like, you know, the hotel the night before, the suits, the travel to the game, walking the pitch, the warm-up? Just if you can give us an insight into what that all is like, and the game, of course, itself, which is the most important bit.
You know, I suppose a mix of everything. It's like you said, it's very professional the whole week up to it. As a player, you know, you wear your suits to the final. So it starts off long before that week, you know, when you're getting fitted for your suits. I know it might be a small detail, but you really feel like a footballer then. You know, you stay in the hotel the night before. Like I said, you do your video leading up to it, have your meeting the night before. So everything's covered, really. And then it's just sort of get your sleep in and go and enjoy the day, take it all in. But like that, when you're there, you've a job to get done. You know, you're there to do one thing only, and that's to win. And, you know, we'll be going there with that mindset that, you know, it's our trophy to take home. And I'm sure Bohemians will be going in with the same attitude that it's theirs. So, yeah, it's a really good day as a player to be involved in. The match, like I said, it speaks for itself in the stadium and the fans. And of course, that feeling knowing of having one cup final before, it's... you know, it really is special. You know, last year with Dundalk, it was taken away with no fans. So this year, you know, fans back for the winner on the day, which will be special.
The actual trip to the stadium on the bus, and when you see the fans for the first time, you know, the Pats fans in their thousands on the way, the Bowls fans also in their thousands on the way, maybe outside the pubs and the hotels around the ground and the restaurants and stuff. And then also, you know, walking out to see the pitch for the first time and you know, that experience of, right, we're here now, some of our family and friends are in the ground and stuff. Before you get to focus on the game, is that something you can actually take in and, you know, use that maybe as that last little bit in your head to go, right, you know, these people are coming from here, there and everywhere to support us? That has to be a nice moment when you're on the bus or arriving to the ground and knowing that they're there in their thousands, literally, to cheer you guys on.
Of course. Like you said, that's all part of the day. Getting the bus through the city and seeing all the fans, that's all part of the build up to it. And you know, some lads like looking out the window, I suppose, and watching it happen. People drunk, falling around, cheering, you know, excited for the day, and then others like to have their earphones in and I suppose be in the zone for the match. But like that, it's all part of the build up, and you know, that's a great part of it. And like you said, then arriving at the stadium and walking on the pitch before you get togged out, it's all part and parcel with it. And, you know, it's all, you know, the build up to the kickoff.
How does it feel then walking out for kickoff, you know, just before the national anthems, when the stadium announcer announces on the teams and you come out to the biggest roar that you've heard as a footballer?
Yeah, that's the best part. Like you said, Jimmy, it's coming out at the start because, you know, the whole stadium is electric at that moment. But, you know, I think you're not thinking past it at that stage. You're fully focused once you come out. And like I said, once you actually take the pitch and kickoff goes, you know, you're not thinking about any of that stuff in your head. You know, you're focused on your individual duties you have to do in the match and as a team as well. So, you know, that soon takes a backseat then once kickoff starts.
And then when the game actually starts, and I appreciate it's a new game and two new teams this year as well, but like always towards the end of the season, the build-up has been so big and there's media days and interviews and photos and people looking for tickets and families and all that sort of stuff as well. But when the game actually starts then, is it easy to flip just into game mode even though the day is so big? And I know you're a professional footballer, that's your job. But is it easy, difficult to actually flip into, right, we've now got 90 minutes here, try and use what's around us but at the same time block it out, if that makes sense?
Yeah, it's no different to, like we said, when we played our last game in Richmond where we had 4,000 or 5,000, you know, it's the exact same. There's an adrenaline and a buzz within yourself when you're coming out and you're hearing the fans and hearing the roar. And, you know, that feeds into the energy of the game. But like that, it's like any game, no matter if there's no one or if it's a full house, once the whistle goes off and kickoff starts, you're fully focused on your duty. So it does sort of blur out a bit once the match gets going.
Lastly, Mounts, what's your thoughts on the game itself and how will you be watching as a St. Pat's squad member who can play? Because there's that lack of control when you've got an injury, unfortunately, and you can't start the game, come on, you know, actually make a physical impact on the pitch. But at the same time, you're just probably cheering the lads on and maybe more nervous watching than you would be if you were playing.
Yeah, exactly, Jamie. That's definitely the hard side to balance out since I've been injured watching the games. You know, I love watching the lads play and we've played such good football this year. I've really enjoyed watching us. But that's, of course, the hard part is when you're in the dressing room and you're listening to the team talks from the gaffer. You know, you have that adrenaline running through you and then you're walking out to the stand just to watch. So it can be tough at times. But, you know, all I'm there to do is encourage lads the best I can and enjoy the matches. But like you said, your nerves to be through the roof when you're actually watching, and you can't, you know, you're really useless, I suppose, in that sense. But, you know, it's a game I'm looking forward to because I've seen how hard the lads have been working recently, and you know, seeing the buzz around it, I'm really looking forward to watching them.
Very lastly, are the suits nice? And did you have any choice in them as a senior pro? Because you're looking very well doing the co-commentary now with us a few weeks ago. So I hope you've been involved in picking nice suits and nice shoes as well, because the shoes at times in the cup final can be fairly controversial.
Yeah, I wish I could pass the compliment there, Jamie, to being looking well on match nights. No, it's look, if I was picking out the suits, we'd be looking a lot sharper. So that's on Alan Matthews. But no, the suits are fine. Like I said, it's a nice touch wearing a suit to the match, but it's about doing the business. We've given PJ plenty of slack about the shoes, but no, like I said, that side of it's not important. You know, it's about showing up on the day and, please God, doing the business.
Great stuff, John Mountney. Thanks a million for your time, and we'll see you on Sunday. The best of luck.
Thanks, Jamie.